In this video, we're talking about visual snow syndrome, one of the most least understood visual conditions that is out there. And today we're talking about the symptoms, how it's diagnosed, and the treatment. Let's take a look. Hey, what's up? This is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. So hit that subscribe button down below and turn on notifications so that we can help you keep taking good care of your eyes. So visual snow syndrome, also known as just visual snow, or sometimes denoted as VS, is a visual condition where people don't see clearly. Instead, they see a lot of little speckled dots on absolutely everything that they're looking at, and kind of reminds you of the static that you'd see on an old television set that wasn't getting good reception. And when someone sees this visual snow, they see this static all of the time, from the moment they wake up in the morning to the moment when they go to bed at night. Now, oftentimes when people have visual snow, they see this static into a really extreme degree, to the point where they're unable to read or function, drive a car, things like that, where some people just have it to a really minimal degree and they can almost just tune it out and ignore it. Now, interestingly enough, this condition is so misunderstood, it's not really in any of my ophthalmology textbooks. Nothing in optometry, ophthalmology, even my visual science book doesn't really go over what visual snow is. It's that misunderstood. I had to learn most of this knowledge from reading a lot of different journal articles and publications, as well as some sort of resource articles. And I'll include additional links to these resources in the description below if you want to read it and review them yourself. What I find interesting is that I actually do have visual snow syndrome. And yes, I did diagnose myself, and doctors shouldn't do that, but it is something that I've had my entire life since I was a kid, and I've tried to describe it to people, but I wasn't sure how to describe it. And I really didn't know that it had a name until other viewers started commenting on visual snow, and I had to do more research on it to understand it. Now, thankfully, I have a very, very mild case of visual snow. I do see the static most of the time. I just kind of tune it out and ignore it. But if I'm in a dark room, especially in the morning when I'm first waking up, or maybe I'm in an exam room when it's really dark, or maybe I'm going to bed and I really just kind of tune things out, I can see the static on everything. And even right now in the daylight in the rooms of the office here, I can actually see this little static on everything that I'm looking at. I think one of the reasons that visual snow is so misunderstood is that people often just don't know how to describe it or really don't mention it to other people. So if you're somebody who has visual snow or you're seeing some sort of different visual phenomenon in your eyesight, go ahead and comment in the section below, because this again is something we need to be talking about. Now, visual snow syndrome actually has other types of symptoms that go along with it. One of the most notably is called nyctalopia, which is the inability to see at nighttime. There's also photophobia, which is extreme light sensitivity, which is also me, hence probably why I picked a career where I am in a dark room all day. There's another one called Palinopsia, where people see continuous trails of moving objects in their vision, kind of like moving your hand really fast, except that you see many, many hands trailing afterward. And there's something called the entoptic phenomenon, which is when people start to see little different spots moving in their vision, something like a blue field entoptic phenomenon, which is when you look at the sky and you see little moving spots. Or this could even include seeing colorful swirls in your vision, whether your eyes are closed or not. Again, that is also me. Again, not everybody has all of these different types of visual symptoms. However, most people who have visual snow have at least two of these symptoms. Now, historically, and not until recently, visual snow was always believed to be kind of an after effect of somebody using hallucinogenic drugs, such as LSD. But in more recent publications, both neurologists and visual scientists have concluded that, yes, you can develop visual snow without any history of hallucinogenic drug use. But it is true that for some people taking those harsh drugs have permanently altered their visual system, and they do see this sort of visual snow syndrome. Unfortunately, at the timing of this video, both doctors and scientists don't fully understand the exact cause of visual snow. However, the popular theory is something called thalamocortical dysrhythmia, which is believed to be a miscommunication between the thalamus and the visual cortex of the brain, at least when it pertains to visual snow. And visual snow has also been reported to be a symptom of other medical conditions, such as persistent migraine aura. That's when you see kind of aura flashing spots in your vision. That's a whole other visual kind of phenomenon that you can experience, which I also have. And if you'd like to see my other video I've done on migraine with aura, I'll hook a link up here in the YouTube card above. And again, I'll put that link in the description below again if you haven't checked that out. But it's also been associated with something called optic neuritis, which is an inflammatory condition associated with multiple sclerosis, as well as inflammatory issues after traumatic brain injury. Now, there are many other bodily symptoms associated with visual snow beyond just the visual symptoms that we've described already. I'm not going to list out all of them because it's a pretty lengthy list, but the most common ones are migraines, a tinnitus, which is a ringing of the ears, and vertigo, which is the feeling of dizziness. So now, if you've been following along in this video, you might have been starting to question, do you have visual snow? And you might be wondering, how is this diagnosed? Well, in the clinic, an eye doctor like myself, or maybe a neurologist, would have to follow through a small checklist in order to properly diagnose visual snow syndrome. So this is that checklist. Number one is that the patient has to constantly be seeing the static of visual snow in their vision, and they have to have it all of the time. Number two is that it can't be associated with a constant like migraine with aura. Again, that's that flashing visual obscuration you can have in your vision. If you're not sure what I'm talking about in terms of the aura, then I do have that video going over aura migraine, and I'll again hook that video up in the description below. Number three is that it can't be associated from any sort of drug abuse, multiple sclerosis, inflammation of the optic nerve, or any other ophthalmic or eye disease. And number four is that it has to be associated with some other symptom, such as photophobia, again, the really very light sensitivity, which is something that I have, some enhanced entoptic phenomenon, which is other visual obscurations, blue field entoptic phenomenon, looking at the sky and you're seeing moving dots. It's something that I see, as well as kind of maybe other color swirls in your vision. That's something that could count for that. You could have nyctalopia, the inability to see at night, and then tinnitus, the ringing of the ears. Those are the more common ones, and you typically have to have one of those other symptoms. Now, since this condition is considered very rare, I've only really diagnosed it on two people, myself and one other patient. Now, certainly other people probably have this visual syndrome. However, they just often don't mention it or talk about it because it's so misunderstood and kind of confusing. But hey, if you are learning something new in this video and finding it helpful, let me know by smashing that like button for me. Now, as far as treatment of visual snow goes, unfortunately, treatment is still very limited. Because it is such an unknown and misunderstood disease, we haven't really found a treatment that is consistent for everybody. Some studies have put patients on different migraine medications. However, they didn't fully get rid of the static. Some studies also suggested changing the diet by decreasing any sort of preservatives or processed foods in the diet, which is something that I think everybody should be kind of striving for. It's overall just good for your entire body. And then some studies even indicate using different filtered lenses. The lenses that have been suggested in studies include yellow lenses, blue lenses, and even the FL41 tint, kind of rose-colored lenses for migraines, have all been suggested. However, in these studies, it's all very subjective. I know when I put on the yellow, the blue, or the FL41 migraine sort of tint, I still notice the visual snow. It doesn't really help me, but it's something that certainly you could look into and try. If you want to look at any of these different lenses that I'm showing here, then I'll include that in the link in the description below if you want to check them out. Again, visual snow syndrome is very misunderstood and underfunded. If you want to learn more about visual snow or perhaps even donate to ongoing research, then I encourage you to check out the Visual Snow Initiative. Those are people who are continually trying to improve the awareness and the research in terms of visual snow and finding a cure for the visual snow syndrome. I was actually lucky enough to speak with some of the people at the Visual Snow Initiative and to get the information to make this video. And if you want to reach out to them, I highly encourage you do. And you can do that by checking out their website. I'll include that link in the description below. Hey, I hope you found this video helpful, but do me a favor, go ahead and comment in the section below if you think you have visual snow or if you're having any sort of visual symptoms. Otherwise, also mention it to your eye doctor because that's going to raise awareness to the eye care professional community about this condition, and hopefully we can all work together to find a cure and better understand the eyes and the visual system. Again, thanks for watching, keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.